So, good morning, friends. Today is the starting of many colleges all over the country. May 1st is the starting date for MS postgraduates. And I had got so many requests from many students to explain a few points about how to proceed with the 3 years. So here I am going to give you the various aspects, various issues, what are the books to read, how to go on with the 3 years. So let us start now. So first year residency, if you see, first years are the backbone of any surgical department. First year PGs are the backbone of any surgical department. The entire department depends upon you, and you will have no time to rest your backbone. That is the first year. So in first year, I'll tell you first one important thing. So far you are a small kid. You have been, until you finish your house surgeon, you are a small kid. You are dependent on your parents, and you have no big responsibility until your house surgeon period. Now when you come to MS or DNB first year, you are the responsible person of a patient or a ward. Now starts the seriousness in your practice. So now you any patient, what you are going to do depends upon 100% depends upon your performance. So your first job is to make your professors realized that you have a great interest in surgery, and you could give the care you could give for the patients is ultimate. Like that, the professors should have confidence upon you. So I will tell you one important thing here. At least 70% of you would have had real interest in taking general surgery. Real interest in taking general surgery. But around 30% of you would have taken general surgery because of the seat that is available there in the counseling. Please remember, never reveal this to your professor. Because surgeons usually, like the postgraduates, should have joined with a real interest in surgery. You might have joined without interest, but definitely you will like surgery at the end of your course. At least 30% will join without interest in general surgery. They gradually develop interest and they become the ultimate surgeons in future. So don't worry that you don't have interest. So best person to learn and understand in your department is from your immediate seniors. The immediate seniors are the people just now out of the stress. So just have good friendship with them. Or even if they don't consider you as a friend, just have good rapport with them. Just obey what they tell. That's what they need. So second year PG is the one person who will lead the first year PG in a right track. No faculty, no assistant professor, no professor, and none of the people like me from speaking in the video can lead you in a correct pathway. Select a good immediate senior, maintain some rapport with him, and proceed according to his guidance. That is the most important thing. Every postgraduate will tell, every postgraduate or every surgeon will tell, what I am today is because of my immediate senior. He told me what to do. He told me how to come out of the stress period. So immediate senior is going to be your godfather for the next 3 years. So have a good rapport with them. First year don'ts. What are the things you should not do in the first year? What are the things you should not do in the first year? So don't involve in department politics. First thing I want to tell this is, many politics will be there in many institutes. Caste politics, native politics, state politics, like that, religious politics, like that, it will keep on going in enormous amount. Don't involve in any department or politics, and don't study anything now in the first 6 months. So I will strictly tell you, don't even think of opening a book and reading for the 6 months. You can read, but read what is needed in the ward. For example, you are putting an ICD. You are going to put an ICD. You can open the PI surgical antigraft book or any clinical case book and learn how to put an ICD. Or just open a YouTube channel, you can learn how to put an ICD. So don't study anything. Don't think of getting a book. And don't, usually the professors and assistant professors don't like a postgraduate roaming with their book. He want the postgraduate to roam with only case sheet and patients. Please remember that. Third thing, don't try to go home or native place very much. Usually you will be homesick. Those who are from various places, they will be homesick. They will try to go home. Sir, please give me permission, sir. One day I will go home and come. Don't do that. Think you are in a military camp. Can you go in a military camp out? You cannot. At least you have phone, WhatsApp, video to talk with your parents or friends or relatives. So please don't ask permission in the first 6 months. You are going to prove what you are in the first 6 months to your department. Okay. And please don't try to speak gossips or ill about anyone. There will be definitely all five fingers are not same. You know that well. Each finger are different. Same way in a department, everyone will be different. One fellow will be psycho. Definitely in each department, each unit, there will be one psycho will be there. He would have become psycho because of various problems he has met in his life. You have to meet that psycho. And definitely there will be a good person, caring person in the department. You have to be very close with him. Like that goes your life. Your life is going to go for the next 3 years with a different category of peoples. So just 3 years, control yourself. Don't get upset. Don't become irritated and don't throw your anger against the assistant professor or professor in the first 6 months. Then you are gone. Your career is gone. If you show any of your attitude in the first 6 months, whoever you may be one of the big politicians son or somebody. But once you don't behave with the good respect, you are lost in the first year itself. So please remember, try to control your anger, try to be soft. 100 people will come and irritate you, but this is the career. Especially surgical career is like that. Surgical career, you have to withstand 6 months stress. That 6 months stress, once you cross, you are going to lead happy life. So please don't involve in department politics. The chief will purposefully, one assistant will purposefully come and tell you. So that assistant is a useless fellow. Don't open your mouth. Just keep your mouth shut. Don't tell, yes, sir, he's a useless fellow. If you tell, they may be having underground relationship and they will tell. They will think you will be speaking about him also same way. So this type of silly politics will be there in any PG department. Not only surgery department, in any PG department. So I request you, please don't involve in department politics. Okay, that is ideal thing for the surgery postgraduate. First year, don't do. First year, what to do? In a first year, please work like a slave. You are a slave. Only a best slave can become a best surgeon. So you in house agency, you can put a notice or you can give 100 things. You can tell, I am house surgeon, why should I go to your shift the patient? Why should I do this work? Why should I put injection like that? But surgeon, you are a surgeon now. The entire department depends upon you. So you should look after the ward 100% under your own care. So there is no other thing except you have to work like a slave for the first 6 months. For the first 6 months, anything happens in the ward, you will be thrown and you will be scolded. Get ready for that. Do surgical training in your home with your pillows or mutton pieces bought in the shop. So you can feel, sir, oh, what, sir, I have taken surgery. They are not even allowing me to touch the knife. They are not even allowing me to take instruments. I will strongly advise you. I used to do this thing. I used to get some sutures, instruments, basic instruments, artery forceps and a needle holder. I will get some suture materials, old expired suture materials from the theater, and I used to put sutures in the pillow. Or I used to go for a mutton shop and I will get a bowl, 1 meter bowl, 500 centimeter bowl. I will keep it in the freezer. I will cut and do suturing. So this you have to learn in the first 6 months. You will not be directly given any chance except for putting a skin suture. There are many PGs completed the 3 years course only with skin suture. So that depends upon the attitude and the way you are going to behave. So for the first 3-6 months, you should don't think about books, don't think about doing some surgeries. Just work like a slave. Be a slave. The best slave becomes the best surgeon. I will tell you again and again. You will understand it once you become the best surgeon. So please buy basic surgical instruments and sutures from theater and learn the skills. Do get familiar with the knots and techniques. There are so many knots, surgeon's knot, reef knot, all those knots you should get trained. You can get them trained just by seeing YouTube or by seeing the various books. Or you can ask your immediate senior. There is always an immediate senior. If there are 5 immediate seniors, there will be definitely one person who will like you and love you. You just get good relation with him and work for him. Whatever he tells you, do. Definitely 3 months, 4 months, he will be your best friend and you both will go to movies and you will enjoy the life after 6 months. So please select one immediate senior who will be with you and learn what are the things he did. So buy some basic books only. Don't buy all the books now. So I strongly advise you to buy only these two books. Kirk's Basic Surgical Techniques. This is a basic technique. If you are weak in this technique, even after 40 years, your technique will be bad. I sometimes see very senior surgeons, even my colleagues sometimes doing surgery, they will be having basic mistake in handling the instrument, in rotating or in holding the instruments, etc. So everything is important. Everything what you are going to do in the surgical field is very important. How you are going to hold the scissor itself is important. Everything is there. How are you going to hold the scissor? How you are going to hold? How you are going to cut? Everything is important. Buy one needle holder. Buy one needle holder, one scissor and one forceps and start doing your suture in your home. That is the only way you can learn for the first 6 months. And PI surgical anticraft is a very basic thing. If you are going to do mistake from this concept, your chief or assistant will definitely question you, have you did a surgery posting in your final year and house surgeon? So please read Kirk and PI in the first 6 months. Don't read any other book. Don't read any other book. Please remember this. I am getting very frequent questions only about reading the books, not about how to proceed the post-graduation. So first year postgraduate, the professors, assistant professors, senior PGs don't like you reading. They want you work. That's all. So please understand, at one stage you may feel, what is this? We are like a slave. But there is one thing you should remember in your mind. You have become a surgeon. A surgeon, in spite of all stress and pressure, you should have a lion's heart, eagle's eye and a soft lady's touch. So in other words, as strong as a lion, as sharp as an eagle, as soft as a lady's fingers defines a surgeon. So you should have all these capacities together. And please remember, the only person in medical field having a definition is a surgeon. Nobody else has such a definition. Okay. So remember this, whenever you feel very bad, whenever you feel insulted, whenever you are thrown out like a piece of dustbin paper, you should remember, whenever you are thrown out, you remember you are having a lion's heart and you will be sharp as an eagle and you will be as soft as a lady's finger. Okay. So the first 6 months gets over now. The last 6 months of the first year residency is going to, now you have been decided in the last 6 months, you are already focused. Okay, this is Mr. Ramu. He is this type. He is Dr. Ramu. He is a good person, a little short tempered. He will shout with the patients. He will do good surgery, but he is always short-tempered. He will be shouting and fighting with the patient and he will create unwanted trouble. Like that, they would have branded you now. Now your brand is established. Now Dr. Ramu, your brand is established. Okay. By this brand, for the first 6 months, you should establish a good brand about yourself. Good brand you should establish. Okay. So try to do all small procedures. Don't hesitate to do any small procedures. Or a circumcision may be given. So you should be ready to face those cases. When they give the first chance, you should prove what you are. The first day you should prove, oh, this fellow is having good hands. The surgeon, the professor will be seeing you, how your hands are going to act after 6 months when you are going given a knife and a suture. That day the professor will decide, this fellow is having a good hand, we can give him case. And prove your hands and make the assistant professor comfortable and confident. You should make them comfortable. You should make them comfortable and confident that he may leave the case to you. From then, your career starts. Once the assistant has confident on you, the assistant professor or your professor gets confident on you, he will tell, leave him, he will do, let us go. Assistant professor and professor will go for a tea out and they will leave the case to you. That day, the career of your starts. So please remember, first 6 months, you should become strong with your basic knotting, instrument holding, suturing, etc. Not from the patient, from outside. Okay. Sir, but we wanted to know what to read. This is the question usually I get from the students. What to read? I told you again and again, I'm telling you, first 6 months, don't read anything except Kirk and PI. Only two books to be read. And if at all, for your question, I'm telling, surgery is not opted for books and journals. Surgery is a course opted by people who want, who love to take knots and knives. So surgery is a course for knots and knives, not for books and journals. You will learn definitely books and journals, but you have to learn as much techniques, as much of methods from various surgeons, from various assistant professors. Even if there is a case going on in the next unit, run to that unit. Even if you are free on an emergency day, if you are free, go into the emergency OT night, 8, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 10 o'clock. Don't hesitate. There may be an obstructed femoral hernia. Never hesitate to go to the theater at that time. Have good rapport with other unit PGs. Ask them to inform you if there is a good case. So learn more and more, not from the books, more from the ward, from the experience of the seniors, and from the experience of the professors. Books and journals can be learnt anytime, and surgeon does not need them. Okay. First year, except for Bailey and Love, I will tell you, don't read anything else. Only read Bailey and Love. Already would have read one time, but at that time you would have read as a undergraduate student. Now if you read the same Bailey and Love as a postgraduate, you will know each and every line how Bailey has made. Each and every line will speak 10 times than what you have read that time. When you have read an undergraduate, you would have read a line. That line would have been read as a line and you would have forgotten it. But now the same line will tell you 10 separate lines. One line will teach you 10 lines. So Bailey and Love is the only book I request first year PGs to read. Thorough Bailey and Love. Don't read any other book if you want to read theory. Bailey and Love, Kirk, Pi. That's enough for first year. Your first year gets over by now. So now you are coming to the second year. This is the honeymoon period, I will tell you. Honeymoon period of not only postgraduates. It is the honeymoon period of your entire medical career, from your first MBBS period to your retirement of your practice. The honeymoon period starts now. Second year period is the honeymoon period. I strongly request you to enjoy this period to the core. This is the time where most postgraduates settled, get married, get their life settled. They will be now around 26-27 years by this second year residency, and most of them, 50-70% of them, will get settled in this second year period only. So don't worry about anything now. Second year period, one advantage is no assistant will question you for work being not done in the ward like a first year PG, and no chief will expect you to know the answer of a tough question which like a final year PG. So enjoy this life during the 12 months. This is a one I will again and again tell you. When you revise back your life after 25 years, you will remember this is the honeymoon period of you. You will never get this honeymoon period again. Please enjoy. Okay? Please enjoy the second year period. Sorry, what else we should do? Usually, second year postings will be extensive. In other words, you will be out of your department. Until first year, you will be inside your department. You won't be allowed to go anywhere. Now, you will be going everywhere. Surgical oncology, surgical gastro, plastic, vascular, cardiothoracic, neuro, urology, endocrine, pediatric, minimally invasive department. Like that, various specialty postings are available. Usually, 6-8 postings will be made for a second year PG. 6-8 postings. You select the best posting and you can be going as an optional requesting your registrar. So you can attend all these postings. Please don't develop any interest in the first year. Don't develop any special interest. Sir, I want to become a neurosurgeon. I want to become a plastic surgeon. Like that, don't develop a interest in the first year. Because I will tell you myself, I had a great interest to become a plastic surgeon. My love and dream was to become a plastic surgeon until I joined MS first year. Once I joined MS first year, after a few months, I went for all these postings. Then I could guess which is ideal for practice in my native place, and which is ideal for earning money. And apart from all, I found I had a special interest and a special love towards surgical gastroenterology than plastic surgery. Then I left out the interest on plastic surgery and I took gastro at the end. So therefore, your interest of course will change once you join the course. So don't develop any special interest now itself. You will, as you keep on going the posting one by one, you will know which suits for you best. You need not select the course. The course will select you. The course will select you and you will join that. So by now, you must get interest. By second year end itself, you will be getting an interest for future. So I will tell you what is a recent trend so that you will get an idea. So the recent, everyone will like which one is ideal. So whichever is ideal, everyone will like. Same way, if you see 2,400 students wrote MCH last year, need super speciality. 2,400 wrote MCH, gastro. Second opted as MCH urology by 2,200 students. 1,800 wrote onco and less than 1,000 wrote other specialities. Other specialities less than 1,000. For example, pediatric surgery and all, only 250 students wrote. So like that means what? That is the craze and that is the scope of those courses. I didn't want to tell anything about the scope of any course. The number of students writing itself will show you the scope of that course. For example, there are 2,400 MCH guest, 2,400 students wrote for only 70 to 80 gastro seat, 70 to 80 gastro seat per year. So this is going to be a big competition in future. So don't worry about it now. Now you can start reading. If you are having an interest towards gastro, now you can buy the books. For a gastroenterologist, there are only two books for super specialty. They are Shackelford and Bloomgard. If you are interested in becoming a surgical gastroenterologist in future, now you buy Shackelford and Bloomgard. It is not a book to be read in 1 year. These books are very big books. You have to read selected topics. For example, your MS curriculum related topics, you can take Shackelford and read. For example, you are reading carcinoma stomach. Take Shackelford and read carcinoma stomach. You want to read hepatocellular carcinoma, it is an essay question. Read it in Bloomgard. Like that it goes on. So you are a future surgical gastroenterologist, select your book to read and select these books, select your topics. Now itself have an orientation about these books. And similarly for urology, it's a most simpler than gastro because there is only one book, 100% all questions will be from this book. So that is one important thing. Urology, if you read this book skin to skin, you are definitely going to get a seat. No doubt in that. The urology seats are, numbers are also more than gastro. Okay. And future oncosurgeons, there is again one book for you, Devita. But I feel personally the toughest to prepare is MCH onco because you have to read extensively. Extensively, you have to read gynec surgery, you have to read orthopedic, you have to read ENT, you have to read general surgery, you have to read oncosurgery, etc., etc., etc. So one of the bulkiest syllabuses comes with oncosurgery. And you have to have a special interest to deal with the cancer patient and you should select this. Okay, it has an excellent scope for future. So I didn't speak about other courses because that's a big scope. If I keep on speaking, the video will take so many time. So let me go with the other things to be done. Theory books for PG residents. What are the theory books to be read for PG residents? So all of you would have read already clinical case DAS or SRB, clinical case examination manual. So how to examine a swelling, how to examine a hernia. This is a very basic thing as an undergraduate. So it is not to be learnt in PG. It should have been learnt by you in undergraduate period itself. So please remember and read these books. Bailey and Love is a must. Sabiston 20th edition is a gold standard book for PG aspirants. So whatever the professor or assistant professor asks you to read, please read Sabiston. There are two reasons. One is all the neat super specialty questions come from Sabiston. All the neat super specialty questions. And apart from all, Sabiston is perfect in its answers. There is no mistake in Sabiston. It is based on the latest journals and this is the latest edition available. So what's the problem is it's a 10th edition going on. If you have a doubt in any concept, if you read SWATS, you will definitely get clarified of that concept. Problem is the book has not been updated so long. Okay. And selected topics you can read from main guts, abdomen, and selected topics from Smith Urology. And you can go with my long cases and short cases because I'm not advising this book for the purpose of, that's my book. That is, I'm not advising for that reason. Once you read the book, you will understand why I advise that. I cannot tell that. You can only see, for example, you take one topic and read from this book. 0 point will be from any other book. I have given only 25 topics. Those 25 topics, all the points are there. Because I have not read, made the book by my own experience. I have taken all the points from all these above books. And I have made as a compiled book of important cases. For example, hernia, it's 100%. Theory point, examination point, everything is 100%. Breast, 100%. Whatever is there in Sabiston, whatever is even is there in Devita, I have taken. So like that, it keeps, that's the reason I'm advising my book. You can just, you will understand it once you join your course. So and operative books. This is what most students will be asking, sir, what operative book I should read? The best book, the gold standard book right from 2000, it is Fisher's Mastery of Surgery. Fisher's Mastery of Surgery is the best surgical book. You can buy this. Please don't put Xerox. You buy the original book. It is colorful and attractive. Excellent book. So please buy this one book in your first year itself. You can buy. You can have in your home. Before going for a theater assisting case, you can use this book, Fisher's Mastery of Surgery. But the only problem is it is full of theory. There won't be much illustration. Sir, I want illustrated, for example, I want operating a hernia, I want illustrated discussion. There is another book for you. Very costly, Robin Smith. It is so many volumes. Every surgery is explained as operative procedure. Steps are there. here I have put only one volume. It's of multiple volume. Each specialty has its volume. What we used to do now, we used to go to library. We take whatever topics essential, we will take Xerox and use that. Because this book at the time in a PG residency, the book at that time was around 25,000. Our stipend was only 8,000 at that time. So we could not buy a book at that time. It is up to you now to buy and a degree. MS period itself. Third part, after finishing MS I completed, it was a very costly course. We have to spend around 2.5 lakhs towards the entire course. There are training available, everything is there. But is it useful in India? Is it useful in India? No use in India. You are not going to get a separate payment for MRCS or a separate salary for MRCS. It will be useful only when you are going to Arab countries or for UK. Otherwise, Royal College of Surgeons of Edinburgh is only a cap, extra cap on your head. That's all. It is an extra cap and you can project yourself. You are a foreign degree holder. But the point is you would have not even visited the foreign. You would have not even visited this college. It is like a correspondence course. Subject is the knowledge you have to know and the subject you have to know is 25% to 40% of what you learned as a PG. So the knowledge is not needed tested in this course. Please remember, MRCS, they don't test you the knowledge. They test you how you approach a patient. That's all. They won't test you the knowledge. They will test you how you are going to approach a patient. So you will learn that if you are really interested in getting an extra degree, putting an extra hat, you can get this course. But I will strongly advise you, if you are definitely going to go for an MCH, don't waste your time on this. You are going to get MCH. You are going to stay in India. Definitely, I will tell you, don't waste your time on this extra hat. It is not going to provide even an extra patient in your practice. I am having this degree and I don't get a patient based on this. If you are going to be an MCH, that will be the ideal than an MRCS. So don't worry about getting an MRCS. It is only for an extra projection. So surgeons always love to get projected. Like I'm a fellowship holder. I'm this fellowship holder. I'm that fellowship holder. But practically speaking, 99% of the fellowships are not learned. They are bought by money. They are bought by money. None of the fellowship in many specialities, many fellowships are just for namesake, for projecting ourselves. And when what is that specialty of that fellowship will be learned, will be known only by a surgeon. That surgeon who got that specialty will know, oh, this one is not a fellowship. We have to pay 1 lakh rupees and get the fellowship. That's all. Same way, MRCS is not a big thing. You can easily get by 2.5 lakhs. So MRCS, another important problem is every year you have to pay 50,000, 70,000 like that for membership maintenance fees. So all these things, only when you go to UK, it will be useful. If you are going to UK or if you are going to Arab countries, you will be considered good salary and you will be considered as a good, you will be put in a good position with these degrees. Otherwise, with the MS degree, you cannot go and survive there. You cannot get a job there. You have to get a job there and to work there in foreign countries, you can use this. If you have 0.1% interest in going to UK also, you can do this. If you have 0% interest, don't do this. Final year postgraduates, now comes the real surgeon. By this time, you have metamorphosed to a real surgeon. Final year resident is the responsible person of the ward. No assistant professor or no professor will know what is happening in the ward except a final year PG. A final year PG is the one who is going to live with the patient and sleep with the patients. So he has to know A to Z about the patients and he has to lead the team. Now comes the leadership quality. First year you are like a slave. Second year you are focused like an eagle. So please remember, first year you worked like a slave. Second year you focused what to do as an eagle. Third year you have become the real lion. The final year is a lion period. So you should work as a lion. You don't do any work. Final year, we don't expect you to do any work. We expect you to extract work from your juniors. That is a leadership. A leader will not do work. A leader will extract work. I expect you to extract work from the second years, third years, house surgeons and maintain the ward without any problem. That is the job of a final year. So final year period is fully power packed period. It is a full power packed period. You are the leader of the team and the department. Consider this in your mind. You are going to. So now you are an MS resident. If you are an MS resident, The way you have worked so far will fetch the result. Nothing to worry. The way you have worked. If you have worked very, ultimately, you are going to get a pass. Your result is not based on the one day performance you are going to have on the exam day. So MS residents, please remember, your result is not based on that one day performance. Unless you make a big blunder, big mistake, you are not going to be failed. You are going to be 100% passed. If you have worked as a good slave and you have worked as a good lion in your final year, then definitely you are going to pass. So don't worry about your pass in MS period. But in a DNB resident, you have to make yourself very strong. You can see most of the DNB residents will be strong in subject than a MS resident because they are compelled to read. They have no other hope. They have to read thorough surgery in theory, clinical, operative, everything. They should be very thorough. So that's the reason many DNB residents have excellent knowledge. Excellent knowledge they have because they have no hope. There will be no professor, no assistant professor to save him in the exam day. They are in single. They have to pass it as a single person. So the one day, your result is based on the one day performance you may have on the exam day. So your one day performance is going to decide you. So please be strong in your subject. Go for many practical exams. Have many orientation programs. That is most important for you. Okay. So some questions which I get usually from the residents. Some queries from the residents. Sometimes I used to feel very much upset. Some students asking some questions. And I used to sometimes feel some students will tell, sir, no, sir, I wanted to discontinue. I don't like surgery. Like that, many questions. Let me answer you in a few words about your queries, what you have in your mind. Number one query, which I usually get in most of the students is, sir, in my department, it is totally waste, sir. They are doing only monthly 4Ks or 5Ks. They don't do any major case. Hands are very less in my department, sir. So don't worry, I will tell you one important thing. You can never work in a department with the less hands than I have worked. I have worked in a unit which for a month we do only 10 surgeries, 15 surgeries. And totally I have seen 15 thyroid operation, 10 breast operation in my unit. That's all. And no laparotomy was done in my unit as an elective cancer stomach or colectomy and all is not done. So but in spite of that, I used to learn the techniques. You have to learn the techniques, how they do, what they do. And whenever time chances available, I used to go anywhere. For example, from Kilpak Medical College, I used to go to MMC also sometimes. I used to go to Raipata Hospital. Because those hospitals, when some important cases posted, I still remember the day, I went 3 times to watch one cancer penis. Cancer penis case was posted in one department. I used to get permission from my chief, sir, please permit me, I want to see one cancer penis. First time I go, they cancelled the case, came back. Second time I went, cancelled the case, same. Third time I went and saw the cancer penis. And you know, when I did the first cancer penis, after finishing MS and after joining in a private institute, after 3 months, I have seen only one cancer penis and I operated a cancer penis reading book, reading Nigus, I did a cancer penis and that patient went well. So like that only, you cannot expect to see all the patients, all surgeries in one place. It is very difficult. So and apart from all, I will tell you one important thing. For example, at that time, during my MSPG, post-MS period, I have done around 50 thyroid in a year. But I don't know to do thyroid now. Just remember, 2008 to 10, I was doing around 50 thyroid per year, thyroid surgeries. But please remember, now after my MCH, I don't know even to do thyroid. So that's why I'm telling. So because I have now focused into gastroenterology, I have now focused more in gastro department. So that is the reason I'm telling. So don't worry about hands being very less and you're not getting any chance. Don't get worried or upset about those things. I'll request you, please leave that. You will learn surgery. You will get an opportunity to learn enormous surgery. After finishing MS also, you can learn. And also please remember, surgery is not a course, 3 years learning course. It is a lifelong learning course. You will be learning, learning, learning. Every time you complete learning one course, another method of surgery will come. And after completing that, another method of surgery will come. So you keep on learning, learning, learning. There is no end for a surgeon's learning. Okay. So don't worry about hands being very less. Best example is myself. I have done a worst unit. There is no case in that unit. No case in that unit. As many students will get, I used to see some students wanted to discontinue the course and go. I had done in a unit where there are very, very few cases and a total case I have did in my MS period was only just some 40 to 50. That see, then observe how my unit I would have been. So don't worry about this. Hands are very less. Except some professors and assistant professors who were there in my unit, they helped me to come out with some smaller cases, and they fine-tuned me during. But once I came out of the department, I am confident of doing all the cases. That is what you need. You should be confident to do any surgery when you come out of the course. Okay. So some other students will tell, sir, in my unit there are so many cases available, sir. But the problem is, all the cases are done by the four assistant professors are there. They are doing all the cases. They are not even giving any chance to, even the final year PhD is not doing any case. I don't think I will get a case in my course. I am again telling you, this is, you cannot get all cases in your PG. You have to observe what I am telling you. Just learn what mistake your assistant professor is doing. What correction, how other assistant is coming and correcting the mistake. What complication happening. How the professor is dealing with the cases. Like that, you have to learn various techniques from vision. You have to memorize all those surgeries in your mind. And definitely you will get a chance one day to correct and do all those things in future. So don't worry about all cases are being done in by assistant professors. Those assistant professors are none but the same PG like you who completed in a unit without any chance. Now he has come to a place where he is getting chances to learn. Definitely, if you become an assistant professor, you also will not give chance to your PGs. That is the scenario, because if you are confident in a surgery, definitely you will give chance to others. If you are still not confident, you will try to do it by yourself only. So you will soon become an assistant professor and you will also learn all those surgeries. So please don't worry about it. Sir, my surgical skill seems to be poor. I used to see some students will tell, sir, when I am holding the instrument, my hands are shivering, sir. I am having small shivering. I am having some difficulty in suture technique. This you can learn. Learn with the pillows and mutton pieces. Mutton pieces, pillow, get chicken. Something you get. You learn suturing, cutting. All those things you should learn. And you should... Practice makes man perfect. There is no doubt it. Whoever here, there is no word like my hands are poor. Definitely, if you keep on learning, you will get good hands. But remember here one point. I want to tell you, some persons will purposely. They are not going to make you live. You are going to live by your own. So don't worry about those insulting, irritating professor or assistant professor. Whatever good you do, they won't praise you. They will only demotivate you. Don't get demotivated by what they say. Definitely there will be another person who will be supporting you and motivating you. So use them and develop yourself. Okay. Sir, I don't like general surgery, but I got trapped here. So very commonly observed point. So you are not got trapped here, guys. You are not got trapped into a surgery department. You have now entered a department where you are going to lead a life of a king. So don't think so as if other courses are you liked and now you have got trapped here. General surgery, you know, it is a legendary course from 1970 when the course was started. The legends are surgeons. In every place, the legends are the surgeons. Wherever you go, who is considered as the master or the captain of the ship is a surgeon. So surgeons are respected and treated like a king in the community. So please don't think you are getting trapped here, but you have done some good thing. That is why you have got into general surgery. You have done some good thing in your previous days or years that made you take a general surgery with compulsion or without compulsion. 70% of them will take surgery with love. And remaining 30% will take surgery and love. We are going to love the surgery. Sir, I am unable to study. Severe work stress here. I already told you, surgery is not taken to study. It is only to experience. So don't worry if you are not going to study. 99% of the postgraduates pass without studying only in the surgery period. They learn surgery, skills, techniques, and they will enjoy. So don't worry you are unable to study. That is, if you want to study, this is not the course. If you are a bookworm, go and take general medicine or a pediatrics. Here, bookworms are not allowed. Okay. So we need people to learn surgery and live with the patients and learn things from the ward. Everything you have to learn from the ward. You can read books, but not for reading, learning the content. You should read books and to see what is happening to the patient. That's all. So please don't worry about not reading, unable to study. I am unable to take the books. During my MCH gastro, for 1 year, I have never touched any book. Please remember, 1 year we have not touched any book. Because we would never get a chance to touch a book. We will be all the time with the patient. Sick patients, dying patients, ICU, here and there, we'll be all the time roaming. And every day is an experience. Every day we see one patient is an experience. So you will learn that experience. Sir, I want to go to abroad. No plan to live in India. I don't like India and Indian surgeons. I want to go to abroad and no plan to live in India. Do you think they give excellent chances in foreign countries for surgeons? Surgeons are the legends there. In foreign countries also, they don't like that post to be given to some other country people. They will, most of the time, they will encroach that post. So to live as a surgeon in other country is one of the difficult thing. So think about it. Okay, difficult thing to live there as a surgeon. So if you are planning to go to abroad with a surgical interest, you will have more difficult time there than in India. Okay, and if you are going to plan to go to abroad, please do FRCS or MRCS. And then do fellowship courses there. So finally, completing here, for other specialty guys, getting the degree is special. But for the surgeon, the dress he wears itself is special. The moment we remove our formal dress and we get converted to the operating dress, there we get a 100% confident and a severe happiness. So that happiness nobody can get. And after completing a surgery and shifting the patient out, the happiness what we get, nobody can get. So proud to become a surgeon and proud to wear the theater dress and an apron and always love to do scrub. The word scrub, apron, scalpel, all these things should make you proud. And be proud. Please remember, and you are going to be the highest earning person in the community than any other specialty. You are going to be the highest earning person in the community in any specialty. It may be late, but not never. You may be earning late, but not never. Okay. So you definitely will earn the best and you are going to lead a happy life. So proud to be a surgeon. I welcome all the surgeons on the board. Any doubt, you can follow us. We have a separate group for practicing surgeons, knots and knives. In Facebook group, so far you have been using my surgery sixer group. Surgery sixer group is only for academic purpose. For actively practicing surgeons, I request you to join knots and knives surgeons group and learn the skills from techniques from various surgeons. And I request you all to post your experiences in your ward in the group itself, and you can share your thoughts with many surgeons are there, specialists are there. You can learn everything from here. So all the best. Thank you.